الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
الحمد لله رب العالمين نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله تعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم وبارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد. All praises due to Allah and may peace and blessings be upon Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. I bear witness that there is no God worthy of worship except Allah سبحانه وتعالى and I bear witness that Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم is his servant and messenger. يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون واعتصموا بحبل الله جميعا ولا تفرقوا All you who believe, be watchful, be mindful and fearful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and do not die except in a state of Islam, in a state of full submission to Allah. All you who believe, hold fast to the covenant of Allah, to the word of Allah, hold fast to your deen, and do not dispute among one another in your businesses and affairs. May Allah forgive all of our sins and mistakes, and may Allah guide us all to the straight path. Allahumma ameen. Brothers and sisters, Allah named our ummah in the Quran as the ummah of goodness, ummah al-khayr. And in the Quran, Allah has given us the message that to survive in that life, iman is not enough. Iman must be accompanied by goodness. And that's why if we reflect on the words of the Quran, when you pass by that combination that always come together, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ وَالْعَصْرِ إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لَفِي خُسْرِ إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ. So the Quran is very clear in that message. For our ummah to survive, and our ummah to exist, and for our ummah to fulfill its mission, we need to invest with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in two things. Number one is to believe in only one God, which we all do, alhamdulillah. And number two is to invest with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in goodness. And perhaps that would be the reason why this ummah continues to exist. Despite all hardships, despite all difficulties, a generation after generation, they invest with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because Allah addressed us in the Quran saying, كنتم خير أمة أخرجت للناس. This ummah and that generation, that Muslim ummah is the best example Allah has chosen for humanity. Why? تأمرون بالمعروف وتنهون عن المنكر وتؤمنون بالله. You fulfill the mission of enjoining what is right. You do what is right. You do what is good. You stand for what is right. You have a position, you advocate for it. وَتَنْهَوْنَ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ. And you stand against injustice. You speak out. You take a position against sinning and committing sins and mistakes. You stand against what is wrong. And above all, وَتُؤْمِنُونَ بِاللَّهِ. You have a firm faith in the only one God. This is our ummah. The ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The ummah that would survive if it invests with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in believing in God and in committing and doing as many good deeds as possible. In another verse, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, and this verse is so beautiful, toward the end of Surah Al-Hajj, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اِرْكَعُوا وَاسْجُدُوا وَاعْبُدُوا رَبَّكُمْ وَافْعَلُوا الْخَيْرَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ. So this ayah of the Quran is just one line long, but subhanAllah, it's very rich in meaning. And it summarizes the philosophy of life. You as a Muslim, your life begins with iman. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. And toward the end of the surah, the ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, لَعَلَّكُمْ تُفْلِحُونَ, that you may gain success. So what begins with iman ends with success, with the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But how? What is the roadmap? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, اركعوا واسجدوا, make ruku' and sujood, or in other words, maintain your salah, maintain your connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَعْبُدُوا رَبَّكُمْ, and do not forget about other deeds and acts of worship. Worship only one God. Make your ruku' and sujood only for Allah. Do not make ruku' and sujood for any human being, for any power, for any civilization, for any being whatsoever. Only make ruku' and sujood for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You worship only Him. وَفْعَلُوا الْخَيْرِ, and do good. Our ummah are commanded, each and every single one of us, we are commanded to do what is good. And because of that goodness, subhanAllah, we continue to exist, and Allah blesses our work and efforts. If I quote an example of goodness, no one is better than Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But the example of goodness I'm gonna quote from his lifetime sallallahu alaihi wasallam, it's even before Islam. before he's officially the messenger of Allah. And we all know the story of the first time he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was attended by angel Jibreel alayhi salam in the cave of Hira. And he's not a prophet yet. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, from that tough experience, he ran down the mountain and he came to the house of a Sayyida Khadija, his wife. May Allah be pleased with her. And he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he was shocked. He was shivering and trembling from that tough experience. And he thought something wrong would happen to him. And as the Sayyida Khadija is calming him down sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and accommodating his fear, he said to her, Ya Khadija, wallahi laqad khashitu ala nafsi. Oh Khadija, I swear to you, I worried about myself. And she, with all certainty and confidence, said to him, Kalla wallahi la yukhzika Allahu abada. No, by Allah, I swear to you, Allah will never disgrace you. Allah will never let you down. Allah will never abandon you. And subhanAllah, from where she came up with that confidence and certainty? He's not a prophet or a messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So what did Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam do so Allah will never disgrace him? And she mentioned five of the qualities of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. None of the five is worshipping Allah. Islam was not there yet. So she mentioned five qualities of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and it shows us the power of goodness in his character. And if Allah has made him our role model, لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ. So alhamdulillah, we need to know more about the power of goodness in the character of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And later on, his legacy, the legacy of Islam, it's a legacy of goodness that survived before Islam, during his da'wah, and after his death sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And because of that power of goodness, we continue to exist. We do exist today. So what kind of goodness Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did before he was a Muslim, and because of that Allah will never disgrace him. She said to him, إِنَّكَ لَتَصِلُ الرَّحِمِ. You keep your ties of kinship. You take care of your relatives and family. You provide for them. You're number one that people rush for you. And because of that, Allah will never let you down. Allah will never abandon you. Allah will never cause you something wrong. وَتَحْمِلُ الْكَلَّ. And you are the one who assists and who helps the destitute. If someone lost the means of life, lost their job, lost their position, someone who's completely lost or bankrupt, they would rush for Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They would never rush to anyone else, but to the man of goodness. They would rush to the power of goodness. And this is one of the best investments for us. If we take that from Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if you are a power of goodness yourself, you carry the legacy of your beloved one. You carry the legacy of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and because of that, Allah will never disgrace you. إِنَّكَ لَتَصِلُ الرَّحِمِ وَتَحْمِلُ الْكَلِّ. And number three, she said, وَتَكْسِبُ الْمَعْدُومِ. And if someone who's completely deprived of any opportunity in life, they could not afford a job, they could not find something to feed on, they could not find anything at all, that's even worse. Not the one who lost their position, no, those who could not even have a position, those who could not even have a job. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, back then, before Islam, was number one to go and help. وَتَقْرِ الضَّيْفِ. Number four, she said to him, you're so generous to your guests. If you invite anyone, if you host anyone in your house, you're the best example of generosity. And he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was described by his companions without much exaggeration as the most generous of all people sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He was not the richest, he was not a king, he was not of the upper class in his society and community, but because of his goodness, he seized and he owned the hearts of everyone, even the disbelievers. We all know the story that they wouldn't trust one another, they wouldn't trust each other, but they would trust the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Despite the enmity and the conflict of interest between Islam and their own interests, and they are plotting and scheming to kill him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he never forgot about it. He assigned Ali, may Allah be pleased with him, his cousin, after him, to return any trust or any deposit back to its people. What kind of message is that? Even at the times of hardship, he's in danger, his life is in danger, but he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam never failed the value of honesty, trustworthiness and truthfulness. As-Sadiq al-Amin. Who in humanity has a role model like ours sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? We proudly speak of him and we proudly carry his message. And number five, she said, وَتُعِينُ عَلَى نَوَائِبِ الْحَقِّ. And if any calamity or catastrophe hit any place of the community, you were number one to rush and help. And because of that, Allah لَنْ يُخْزِيكَ أَبَدًا. Allah will never disgrace you. Imagine, that was our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Before Islam, once he became officially the messenger of Allah, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala addressed him, يَا أَيُّهَا الْمُدَّثِّرُ قُمْ فَأَنذِرْ. Oh, the one wrapped in blankets, get up and preach Islam. You're officially the messenger of Allah. Since then, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught us that to survive and to succeed and for our deen to continue to present, to be present and to exist, we need to invest with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So brothers and sisters, as we believe in Allah, we should never forget about the other wing, which is investing with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in goodness. Goodness is not an option for you as a Muslim. Al-khayr and doing good is not an option. It's mandatory. Allah said, وَفْعَلُوا الْخَيْرِ. In other verses of the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَسَارِعُوا, which means rush for goodness. Hasten for it. When you find any opportunity, try to be part of it. Rush to take part in. Number three, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, سَابِقُوا إِلَى مَغْفِرَةٍ رَبِّكُمْ. Not just rush, compete for it. And in another verse, Allah said, وَفِي ذَلِكَ فَلْيَتَنَافَسِ الْمُتَنَافِسُونَ. We even compete for goodness. We speak of it. We try to be part of it. If you have any good cause in your society and community, you as a Muslim, as a follower of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you're expected to be number one. This is what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam taught us. So we invest with Allah. And Allah said in the Quran, مَنْ ذَا الَّذِي يُقْرِضُ اللَّهَ قَرْضًا حَسَنًا فَيُضَاعِفَهُ لَهُ أَضْعَافًا كَثِيرًا. Who amongst you would have that business with Allah? And in return, Allah would give it back in many, many multiples. So you as a Muslim, you do good because you are commanded to do what is good. It's part of your deen. It's part of your faith. And number two, you do it as an investment with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We invest with Allah. And this is the best kind of trade and the best kind of business when you invest with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Number three, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is warning us, when you do something good, do not show off. Do not expect any appreciation or recognition from anyone, whomsoever. Only expect appreciation, acceptance, and recognition from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, وَرَجُلٌ تَصَدَّقَ بِصَدَقَةٍ فَأَخْفَاهَا. And a man who gave a sadaqah, and he or she, they hid it. حَتَّى لَا تَعْلَمَ شِمَالُهُ مَا تُنْفِقُ يَمِينُهُ. To the extent that the left hand wouldn't see what the right hand did. Of course, it's a metaphor. So no one would know what kind of good deed or act you do. You do it for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Do not expect your name to be mentioned in public, because that's not what you hope for. You need your name to be mentioned and recorded in heaven, not here on earth. Because what is here on earth, it remains here on earth. And what goes to the life after is what you invest and what you deposit there in your account in the life after. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, وَيُطْعِمُونَ الطَّعَامَ عَلَى حُبِّهِ مِسْكِينًا وَيَتِيمًا وَأَسِيرًا. Allah gave us the example of feeding the poor and the needy. And he said, إِنَّمَا نُطْعِمُكُمْ لِوَجْهِ اللَّهِ. Indeed, when you provide that food and you feed the poor and hungry, you do it for the sake of Allah. لَا نُرِيدُ مِنْكُمْ جَزَاءً وَلَا شُكُورًا. We're not expecting any reward, anything back, nor appreciation or recognition except from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You as a Muslim, you do good because it's mandatory. You do good because it is the legacy of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and all of you had that honor to carry that legacy of goodness. And number three, you do not show off. You do not seek any appreciation or recognition from anyone. You seek it only from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And number four, and that's quite important. It has never been about how much you give. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم لا تحقرن من المعروف شيئا. Never belittle any good deed you do, no matter how small it is. Again, never belittle any good deed you do, no matter how small it is. ولو أن تلقى أخاك بوجه طلق. Even if it's as simple as smiling at someone's face, do it. Allah appreciates it. Allah takes care of it. Subhanallah. Many people among the Sahaba who were poor, and they came to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and they complained for him, and they said, "Ya Rasulullah, ذهب أهل الدثور بالأجور." The people of wealth and richness, mashaAllah, how lucky they are! They got the best of this life, and they secured the best position in the life after. And of course, it's because of our human calculations. It has never been about how much you give. It's all about your intention and about acceptance from Allah. إِنَّمَا يَتَقَبَّلُ اللَّهُ مِنَ الْمُتَّقِينَ. And they said, how? It's not fair. We don't have much to give. So when you ask for sadaqah or there's any good cause to help and support, I give $1 or $2 and mashallah they give 10,000 or 1 million. So it's not fair. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, in a similar occasion, he said, سبق درهم 100,000 درهم. One dirham, the currency of the time back then, let's say $1, exceeded a reward 100,000. And they said, how, O Messenger of Allah? How? And he sallallahu alayhi wasallam said, the one who gave the $1, subhanallah, all he had in his pocket is just $2. So when he gave one of them, technically, he's in a very dire need for that. But he gave 50% of his wealth for the sake of Allah. Is it equal with someone who gave 100,000 and it's even less than 1% of what they have? It's not the same with Allah. And again, this is not an invitation to discourage those who give 10,000 or 1 million from giving. No, continue to give. But keep in mind, at the times of ease, give as much as you can. At the times of hardship, continue to give. Even if you are in need, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, لَن تَنَالُوا الْبِرَّ حَتَّى تُنْفِقُوا مِمَّا تُحِبُّونَ. You wouldn't attain birr, piety, and goodness until you give from what you like, you love the most, what you like the most. So subhanallah, you give. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, لِيُنْفِقْ ذُو سَعَةٍ مِّن سَعَتِهِ. Let those of wealth and richness give accordingly, give as much as they can according to what Allah has given to them. وَمَنْ قُدِرَ عَلَيْهِ رِزْقُهُ. But those of little share in this life, فَلْيُنْفِقْ مِمَّا آتَاهُ اللَّهِ. Let them give accordingly. No one is exempted from giving as a follower of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. لَا يُكَلِّفُ اللَّهُ نَفْسًا إِلَّا مَا آتَاهَا. Allah would never overburden anyone beyond their capacity. سَيَجْعَلُ اللَّهُ بَعْدَ عُسْرٍ يُسْرًا. With hardship, by the will of Allah, comes ease. إِنَّ مَعَ الْعُسْرِ يُسْرًا. This is what Allah promised, and that's what we believe in. Brothers and sisters, our ummah is the ummah of goodness. And the followers of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, which means all of you, you are all a power of goodness. And the ummah and Islam will continue to exist because of all of you. 14 centuries ago, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he stood up in the desert of Arabia, in the middle of nowhere. And he said, لَا يَبْلُغَنَّ هَذَا الْأَمْرُ مَا بَلَغَ اللَّيْلُ وَالنَّهَارُ. This matter of our deen, this Islam, will be everywhere on planet Earth. بِعِزِّ عَزِيزٍ أَوْ بِذُلِّ ذَلِيلٍ. And subhanAllah, if anyone among the non-believers is passing by, they would laugh at him. It's isolated area. But he promised, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala fulfilled the promise of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Here we are. MashaAllah, look at all of these masses. We continue to gather to pray Jumu'ah and Jama'ah. We have all of these masajid, all of these organizations. 14 centuries after the death of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Isn't it strong enough that Allah fulfilled the promise of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? And if Islam reached us here in North America in 2023, there is a higher chance that this deen continue to exist for another 14 centuries, inshallah. And what we believe in, of course, Allah says, لِيُظْهِرَهُ عَلَى الدِّينِ كُلِّهِ. This deen of ours will continue to be dominant until the day of judgment. So don't be worried about the future of Islam. Never be worried about the future of Islam. What you should worry about, did you do your job or not? Are you part of the process or not? 14 centuries, many generations, mashallah, everyone did their job. And alhamdulillah, because of all of you, if none of you showed up today, there will be no Jumu'ah and no Jama'ah. But because of you, Islam is being established. Islam does exist because of you. You chose to be here. But wallahi, I see the other way around. You did not choose to be here, by the way. You have your free will. It's a free country. But Allah has chosen you all to be here, to establish His deen through all of you. So what you should do always, you make that beautiful dua. Allahumma istamilna wa la tastabdilna. Oh Allah, continue to make use of us. Do not exclude us. Because we have many people outside who do not care about the masjid, who do not care about Islam. But Allah has made you and your families and wives. You dedicate that time and Allah made it easy for all of you to show up. So Islam is established and Islam does exist in America because of you, or because Allah has chosen you to establish His deen through all of you. May Allah continue to make use of us for His deen. May Allah forgive all of our sins and mistakes. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم فاستغفروا. الحمد لله رب العالمين الحمد لله لا أبغي به بدلا حمدا يبلغ من رضوانه الأمل ثم الصلاة على خير الورى وعلى ساداتنا آله وصحبه الفضلاء. Brothers and sisters, any investment with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala never fails, and Islam continues to exist because basically generations of generations from the time of Sahaba to our time continue to invest with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to serve that deen. The Quran, as an example, is the word of Allah that remained unchanged from the time of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The only word of Allah on planet Earth that remained untouched, unchanged. How? Because of the dedication. Because each and every single one of the Muslim Ummah from the generation of Sahaba to our time, they do the act of da'wah by memorizing the Quran, by learning and documenting the Quran, by delivering the Quran to all humanity. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, this Quran is a message for all people. قُلْ يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسُ إِنِّي رَسُولُ اللَّهِ إِلَيْكُمْ جَمِيعًا. And Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam commanded us, I mean each and every single one of us, all of you. He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, بَلِّغُوا عَنِّي وَلَوْ آيَةٌ. Pass the knowledge of the Quran on my behalf, even if it's just one verse. So the Quran, the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is our responsibility. And alhamdulillah rabbil alameen, Quran is accessible to all humanity today, and our job is to continue to deliver the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's what I am here for, knocking the doors of that generous community, inshallah, to show support to the word of Allah and to fulfill the command of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam by giving the Quran and making it accessible for free for every single human being. In our case, alhamdulillah, I came and I am speaking in the name of Furqan Foundation in Chicago. In the past 20 years, we've been in that job and we had the honor to deliver the word of Allah to all humanity. Basically, we have two of the best translations of the Quran. One is in English and the other one is in Spanish. And alhamdulillah rabbil alameen, believe or not, among each 100 people who read these copies of the Quran, the translation of the meanings, 25 of them become Muslims. سبحان الله والله without any extra effort on our side. This copy that you may sponsor today for $2 only, and we give it out on your behalf. And it is a reason for someone to be guided. What is the reward for that? The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, لأن يهدي الله بك رجلا خير لك من الدنيا وما فيها. If Allah makes use of you to guide only one person, that's better for you than the whole world and what is therein. Alhamdulillah, if you sponsor 52 copies, that's one box of the Quran. You give a chance for many people to be guided. Or if you sponsor 100 copies of the Quran, inshallah ta'ala, there is a room for 25 people to be Muslims. A beautiful story, short story, and it's actual one, and I conclude with that, inshallah ta'ala. Wallahi, a lady, a month ago, she's 83 years old. She found that copy of the Quran in my hand. She found it thrown away. And look at the journey of that copy of the Quran, that you may sponsor it, and we give it to someone, and someone threw it away, and a different person came to pick it up. Look at the journey, and look at the goodness, how Allah takes care of it. He threw it away. And this lady who was 83 years old, she picked it up. She went home. She read only 20 pages. She didn't know what is that, what is Quran. But she's like, okay, that's very interesting. I need to call someone. In the last page, she found the hotline for Furqan Foundation in our office. And alhamdulillah, the manager responded to her. And she said to him the following. I lived for 83 years old. And in the past 80 years, I've been looking for many, many answers, for many questions that occupy my mind. But today, I could find the answers for my questions. For only reading 20 pages. I don't know, wallahi, what 20 pages of the Quran she read. And what, but look at the guidance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Look how Allah takes care of your sadaqah. And she continued the conversation and asked many questions. And she did not hang up and close the phone line before saying, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammad Rasulullah. At the age of 83. Subhanallah, look at the journey of the book that you may sponsor today and will give to someone, and he or she threw it away. But subhanallah, it falls at the hand of someone, and how Allah made use of those even who threw the Quran away to guide someone else. It's an investment with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Right after salah, inshallah ta'ala, we have our table outside here. So please, if you feel that you need to sponsor some copies of the Quran, inshallah ta'ala, to give it out on your behalf, as sadaqah jariyah for you and your families, more than welcome to continue our mission that never stopped. In the past 20 years, alhamdulillah, every year we pass out more than 1 million copies of the Quran. And the number of people who convert to Islam or those who know about Islam, alhamdulillah, we do our job. So please take the responsibility today as followers of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And whatever comes out, inshallah, if you sponsor one box of the Quran or two boxes or three boxes or any number of boxes, inshallah, may Allah accept it from all of you. Allahumma ighfir lana dhunubana wa israfana fi amrina wa thabbit aqdamana wa ansurna ala man adana. اللهم كل إخواننا المستضعفين في كل مكان من أرض الإسلام اللهم كل إخواننا المستضعفين في غزة يا رب العالمين اللهم أيدهم بمددك اللهم أمدهم بجندك اللهم اجعل الدائرة لهم على عدوهم وعدوك يا رب العالمين ربنا أفرغ علينا صبرا وتوفنا مسلمين ربنا اغفر لنا ولإخواننا الذين سبقونا بالإيمان ولا تجعل في قلوبنا غلا للذين آمنوا ربنا إنك رؤوف رحيم وأقم الصلاة إن الصلاة كانت على المؤمنين كتابا موقوتا